Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this short tip, I will show you guys how you can create this cool paper texture effect in Adobe Photoshop. And also, I will show you guys how you can place text or images on top of the texture and create a realistic paper text effect as well. So let's get started. First, create your new document and then select gradients. In the gradient settings, select the basics, and in here select the default black and white. Okay, then select OK. In the type of gradients, select the diamond, which is the fourth one in here. And for the mode, in the gradient mode, you have to select the difference. Now you guys can draw the gradient like this in here. You can have different sizes. You guys can control your texture by these diamond placement. For an example, let's say in here, you want to have more wrinkles. You can have more gradients like this. Okay. So I'm just going to randomly place them in here, different sizes. I think this is good enough for this example. Now go to the filters, and in the filters, go to stylish and select emboss. Now you guys can see, based on our black and white value, Photoshop has created the emboss into the base artwork. And now we can control this in here. You can make the height bigger or lower based on your requirements, and also the emboss value you can control from here. I'm just going to stick to something like this in here. And then once you're satisfied, just select OK. Final step is controlling the color. So select levels, control L. And in here, I'm going to select the midtones and going to bring down like this. Okay. And if you guys want to make the shadow a little bit more stronger, you can bring the shadows a little bit to the inside. Okay. And then you guys can select OK. So this is how you guys can easily create paper texture in Adobe Photoshop. And also you guys can do one more thing. So I'm going to repeat the same process. Go to file and new. I'm just going to stick to the same size. In here, I will select the gradient. You have to select the diamond gradient and mode to diffuse. And now I'm just going to place randomly like this. Okay. Before I move on to the next step, I will add in one more step for this paper. So we will have some paper texture in the final artwork. For this, go to filters, and in here, go to noise and add a noise. Okay. In the noise, make sure you have selected the monochromatic below, and you can bring down the texture a little bit lower like this. You can see our noise texture is affecting nicely in these areas, these black lines, and also in these areas. This is what I'm looking for. If you add in a lot of noise, it won't work properly in your final artwork. So you have to stick to somewhere around here and select OK. Now we can move on to the next step. Go to filters. In the stylus, select the emboss. Okay, now we can control the settings in here. I'm looking somewhere around here. We can bring up the amount a bit, so we will have nice foldings in here. And also this one, we can bring it around here. All right, and select OK. And now we can go to the levels again, Control L, and we can adjust the midtones to lighter like this. All right. Okay, so this looked like a proper paper with the paper texture. And if you guys want to change the color for this paper, you can create a new layer. And in here, you can apply a color. For an example, if you want to apply a yellow color paper, so you can select this color and apply to this layer and make this layer as multiple. So it will nicely blend in with the background layer. And the third step is, if you guys want to apply this bump to the layers on top, let's say for images on top or for text on top of this to look even more realistic, you guys can do that very easily. Just hide this color layer, use the black and white layer, and go to file and save as a Photoshop file, and just save this one as paper texture. Okay, this is going to be the texture for our bump map in the next layer. So I'm just going to say bump texture. All right. And now I can on my color layer, and then I'm going to add a text on top like this. All right. And for this, let's add in more text. Okay, so this one is good enough. And now, if I want to blend this text in with the background, I can go to the blending mode, and in here I can apply a blending mode multiple like this. This look okay, but to have it even more realistic, what you can do is select this and go to filters, and in here go to distort and select displacement. You have to convert this layer into a smart object before you can apply this filter. So convert this to a smart layer. And now I'm going to select horizontal scale, maybe because it's a text, I'm not going to apply a lot. Maybe I will apply 5. And for the vertical scale also, I'm going to apply 5. And the other things, I'm just going to as it is, since the size is same as our original artwork, and select OK. And in here, you have to select the bump map you have created. For this, I have created this bump map, and I'm just going to select OK. Now, if you guys see, we have this text nicely blending in with the texture and also the bump in here. Okay guys, so we can do the same for the images as well. So I'm going into this artwork in here, and first I'm going to save this one as a bump map. Okay, so let's go in, and I'm just going to save this as bump texture 2. All right, and for this I'm going to import an image, just place in here. All right, and I just place it in here. Okay, now let's go to the filters, and in here select the distort and displace. We can have it 10-10 for now, and select OK, which is this one in here. And if I zoom in, guys, you can see how our image has been affected with the bump. And you can double click in here and increase the bump if you want to. Let's say if I want 25%, 25 in here. Again, you have to select the bump map, which is this one. Now you can see our bump map is nicely placing into these edges like this. Okay, and now we can just go into the blending mode and select the multiple blending mode, which will blend in with the background and give you guys the illusion of paper blend effect in here. Alright guys, so this is how you can easily create your paper textures and artwork on top of it. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.